Hare Krishna. Many a times when I speak on the importance of health and cows, I always say that it is very important to laugh, to be healthy, as we hear from others. But after a lunch program, you know, sometimes it's important to clap also, so it's a wake-up call for others. I don't see everybody, you know, maybe there are a few others taking rest. I have, as our conference, the name is Cow Culture. So I want to, in a minute, offer my gratitude to all of those because of whom I started serving cows. Firstly, my Guru Maharaj, who asked me to serve cows personally. Govind Prabhu is also my mentor. And in India, in Bombay, where I stay, we have Uttam Maheshwari Ji, Gopal Bhai Sutaria, Sunil Mansingha Ji, and Dr. Pache Gaonkar, who are like my guides. And if you travel in India or if you search about them, you know that they have done a considerable amount of work in cow protection. So once I was with Uttam Ji, and the chairman of Vidya Bharati came to him. I mean, if you know Vidya Bharati has around 28,000 schools all over India. And as we ask in Hindi, kya hal chal hai? Like, how are you? So he said, hal to theek hai, lekin chal theek nahi hai. Like, I'm okay, but I can't walk properly. He said, what's wrong? He said, no, you know, doctors said that, you know, after you are 60, you know, you can't stop your pain in your feet, especially the knees. He said, my knees are very bad. So he said, what did doctors say? He said, doctors said that, yeah, you can do some physiotherapy, or you can take some medicines, and you know, you can just minimize the pain, but it will remain. So Prabhuji asked him that if I can help you out. He said, please, I'm eager. So he said, just do two things. He said, never drink water when you're standing. He said, that's it? He said, yes. And another thing, he said, in milk, fresh cow's milk, you add little turmeric, and you boil it, and you add ghee. And you know, like how you mix it with cups, you know, not with a spoon. You know, in Hindi we say, you know, ghee ko chamchegiri pasand nahi hai. Ghee doesn't like, you know, it doesn't like that you just stir it with a spoon. So you, in Vrindavan, how they do, usko fetna bolte Hindi mein. You just, you know, stir it and you drink it while standing. Why? Because milk has calcium and it will go to your bones. And it will strengthen your bones. So such a simple remedy. Drink water always while sitting. A chair is okay. I mean, nowadays anyways, nobody wants to leave a chair. But for drinking water, a chair is fine. You can sit on the chair and drink your water. And milk, you should always drink while you are standing. And with just turmeric and ghee. And then you see. So a few days later, I again happened to be with him and he said, you'll get at least 20 to 30% benefit. He said, I never knew that you go bhaktas lie so much. This gentleman said. He said, why? You know, what happened? He said, you said I'll get 25% better. I'm almost 70% better now. Just by following these small tips. So this is the power of our mother cow. Cow is our mother. A mother will do anything to give all pleasure or all comfort to its children. So the cow has prana shakti, and as you know, we heard about the Bos indicus breed that can enhance the prana shakti more. Even in our scriptures, it is said, Krishna tells Nanda Baba, sarve devaha gava mange tirthani tat padeshu cha tat guyeshu swayam lakshmihi tishtat eva sadapitah. Sarve devaha gava mange, all the demigods reside in the body of a cow. Tirthani tat padeshucha, and in her hoofs, all the holy places, the tirthas, they reside in the hoofs of a cow. Tad guyeshu swayam lakshmi, in cow dung. Lakshmi ji resides in cow dung. Tishtat eva sadapita. Krishna is telling Nanda Baba. In Mahabharata, there is a story. Lakshmi ji comes and she tells mother cow, you have given place to each and every devi and devata, all the demigods and goddesses, but not me. She said, if you don't respect me, then who will respect me? So mother cow said, you know, those who are flickering by nature, those whose faith is flickering, they cannot have place in the body of a cow. Lakshmiji begged, 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 begged mother cow that please, please do something. She said, okay, you stay in cow dung. And Lakshmiji was grateful. She said, you know, you are so kind that you have given me place in cow dung. Not like, what cow dung, you know, you have given me place in cow dung. Not like that. She was extremely grateful that mother cow has given her place in cow dung. That's why it is said that those who regularly take cow urine and cow dung, they remain healthy, which I am coming to my topic now. And also, I heard this in Hindi, I would like to repeat in Hindi and translate. They say that unhe dal aata ka ghata kabhi nahi hota hai. Because Lakshmiji resides in cow dung. They will never fall short of anything. Just because Lakshmiji resides. I was reading a BBC article, a report, that cow dung has a chemical called serotonin. Nowadays, children are very hyperactive and, you know, we get tensed over trifles, we fight over trifles, of course, a symptom of Kali Yuga. But in olden days, our houses were plastered with cow dung. So naturally, we used to inhale cow dung. And because of that, it soothes the mind. Serotonin is a happy hormone. It will make you relaxed. So that's why, because nowadays, we are so cut away from nature, you know, we get angry over trifles. But and cow dung is especially good, that inhaling of cow dung, especially the best for growing children. And it can cure a host of diseases like asthma and bronchitis. There's a BBC paper on it. If anyone wants, I can show later on. So there are n number of benefits by cows. Usually I give a 6-hour presentation and Prabhuji told me to sum up as early as possible. I will just touch base and if anybody wants, I will be around. We can discuss in person. There are various ways of making ghee. Mostly people make ghee by cream. They just boil the milk and take the cream. But that ghee will cause cholesterol, will increase the bad cholesterol and eventually heart attack. And that's why ghee is not popular nowadays because it's not made in the traditional way like Mother Yashoda used to make. We boil the milk, we put culture, yogurt. Of course, I do it in an earthen pot because it's always the best. On cow dung patties, that is even better. And then, but anyway, if that's not available, that's fine. We boil the milk, we add culture, and we make fresh butter. And fresh butter, we churn it, hand churn. If you don't have a hand churner, even a motor is okay. But best is if you hand churn it, and then from the fresh butter, you make ghee. We make ghee, and we take 25 liters of milk to just make 1 kg of ghee. But that is pure. That is like Amrit. And there are various uses of ghee. I mean, it's beyond the scope of my presentation now. If somebody wants, I can WhatsApp also. There are 35, 40 uses of ghee, which are proven. It has n number of health benefits by taking that kind of ghee. Even the ghee which is put in nose, it's a miracle. I have personally seen, I saw a girl, she used to get fits, what's it called, epilepsy. And usually people get fits like twice or thrice a week, but that baby, that girl, she got thrice in a day. And we told her to put this pure cow ghee in her nose. And every day her mother was in North India, they used to call that nothing is happening for 2 months. And after 2 months, we said, just continue. They didn't call back. And we found out that never ever, it's last 3 years, that she never got fits again. Cow dung can cure 90 ailments above upper collarbone. 90 ailments, sorry, cow ghee, not cow dung. Pure cow ghee can cure 90 ailments above upper collarbone. I mean, I have a personal story. I also have a house in Mayapur, and my wife was in Mayapur, and she had some infection in her ear. So I told her, you please put ghee in your nose. She said, I have infection in my ear. I said, put ghee in your nose. She said, I have an infection in my ear. I said, you have problem in your ear, not me. Put ghee in your nose. And believe me or not, within a couple of days, everything was okay. There are n number of things. It's good for eyes. It's good for anything. People are in coma, in paralysis. It is miracle. And how do you do it? Just take a cup of hot water and a small glass bottle. Just melt the ghee a little bit by putting it in hot water. Put 2 drops while you're resting. And of course, don't drink water after that. And don't talk 5 minutes at least after that. But maybe you'll get a good night's rest after that. And then, and just see the miracle. Don't even like try to pressurize it or suck it inside. Pull it inside. Just put that much and see. It will help you like in many, many, many ways. Why? Because that cow, again I said, has prana shakti. She has that healing power. She's mother. And it has been proved. You can just experiment and see. I was staying in Govardhan Eco Village in 2008-09, and there were only Indian style toilets. So after using Indian toilets, I used to limp. I had problem with my feet. And we did MRI, CT scan, and what not. And nothing, I was not getting cured at all. Then I went for a conference. I met Mr. Mehta. He's the chairman of, he was one of the main trustees of Vagaldhara Hospital in Valsad district in Gujarat. There is a cancer cure hospital. They have treated 4,000 cancer patients just with Panchagavya, with all the products from Mother Cow. So he told me, whenever somebody comes to me with a pain in foot, again, that is also you have to do with your milk and drinking water, sitting down. He said, just put your foot in cow dung for 5 minutes. Or take a chair and, you know, just put your foot in cow dung. Just do it for a week, he said. So I stopped wearing shoes in our Goshala. And then I just forgot that I have pain in my foot. And I had tried N number of doctors, orthopedics in Bombay. Nothing had worked. So cow dung has that power. Now I have seen many people do this and they are getting cured. And they are getting better. So every product from cow is useful. Just if we learn to utilize the cow properly, you know, we will be successful or we'll be happy. So in our trying to preach about mother cows, although milk is most important product, but you know, cows are killed when there is no, when they don't give milk. So we preach, we try to educate that cow dung and cow urine are the most important products of a cow. We make N number of things from these things. Apart from fertilizers, pest repellents, even like a mundane activity like brushing our teeth, if we try to use very good quality tooth powders made with cow dung and many other ingredients, such a mundane activity like even brushing our teeth will support the economy of gopalakas, of persons who are trying to serve cows. In America or even in Bombay, it's legal to keep a dog in your house, but it's illegal to keep a cow. So if wherever you are staying, if you just try to use these products, you are supporting mother cow wherever she is. Just like we have to water the root of a tree, our teeth, the roots of our teeth are the gums. If you take the tooth powder and lightly massage on our gums and let it rest for a couple minutes, within a week you will see how much better your teeth are stronger. You'll feel that your teeth are really have become stronger. We make powder that is Uptan or Angaraj they call for bathing. Many other ingredients are also added, natural ingredients. And if you bathe with that, you will not get fungal infections, you will not smell, you will not get body odor. Plus, if you have a tiring day, and students or everybody, you know, you come from office, you just apply it on your face, allow it to rest, and wash your face, you will feel all your fatigue has come out. That is the power of cow dung. And even for women, it is like a natural face pack. You don't have to do anything else. So there are so many benefits just by cow dung and cow urine, and I'm just touching a few of these. So we just request that if we tried, and I wanted to speak on cow urine, but I heard that somebody else is giving a presentation that by taking cow urine we can cure so many diseases. So I'm not touching on that because somebody else is going to talk about cow urine. So I just want to say that, as I said earlier, that if we just try to learn how much the cow is useful, then our life can be successful. Even when a cow leaves her body and we bury her, and after a year we again take her and we burn, we get potash worth 50,000 rupees, NPK for agriculture. So potassium is very much necessary, which enhances the growth of fruit trees. So there are so many benefits of a cow. And milk cow at times gives, but cow urine and cow dung from the time of her birth till she leaves her body, she will always give. So if we try to use these products, we are helping mother cows to sustain and to be happy. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. And I also want to say that whatever I am trying to speak about mother cows or to serve mother cows, it's vastly due to inspiration of His Holiness Bhakti Raghava Maharaj. In 2009, in Mayapur, when I lost my father, I went for immersion of ashes. I didn't even go to Yoga Peeth because Maharaj was giving a seminar. I was mesmerized, absorbed, and from then I have read each and every of his book, And I'm just taking all inspiration from whatever I'm doing because of His Holiness Bhakti Raghava Maharaj. His Grace Vasu Ghosh Prabhu is also here, who is also one of our guides from India, who allowed me to do what I'm doing. So I'm very grateful to you, Maharaj, for this. So at this point, if somebody has a question, one or two, we will take, because we're already running late, or we can, otherwise we can speak in person.
Hi.
Yep.
Yeah, I just wanted to know that you mentioned some such great things, and I think it's very important in the United States today, of what you mentioned, of what you said today, because being a doctor myself, I totally understand where you're coming from, especially because of natural medicine that you're talking about. So the ghee, if you could just explain a little bit how it's made, so I will talk about it in my radio show.
Certainly, as I said, that we have pure cow milk, we boil it. And after boiling, when it comes to 45 degrees temperature, if you want to measure, we put culture, yogurt. And then from that yogurt, we churn it. It's maybe difficult to hand churn. You have a motor which has double action. It churns, it makes fresh butter. And that fresh butter is heated and made into ghee. But the cow has to be happy. We feed our calves two tits. So we don't deprive the calf of the milk. See, it's a hormonal secretion. As much the cow is happy, that much in a happy mood she will give milk. So we try to do that, and I think it's a lengthy answer. I have some pictures. I can meet you in person and we can talk. So anybody else, or we can just wind up? Yeah. Thanks. There's a microphone.
Thank you for explaining about, you know, ghee process and all those things. But my question is there a way we can order ghee from you?
Certainly we can order ghee. The ghee which we have on the counter outside, it is made by following this process. Because what is not appealing to us, we will not bring, especially for sale. And you can contact my friend Shri Krishna Purushottam, who stays in the Bay Area. And he will certainly make you available the best quality ghee possible.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
The last question we can take, if you allow.
Very quick question. Regarding putting ghee in the nose, what is the ratio of water to drops of ghee?
Just one or two drops of ghee in the nose. That's it.
With water?
No water.
No water.
Just melt the ghee. I said take a cup with hot water. Just put a glass bottle inside it so it melts. And just put it, even you don't have to suck it also. You know, just like, it just has to be there. You have to rest with it. And just try and see, it's a miracle. You know, my friend who is an engineer, when he heard about what I'm trying to say, once we were talking, he had a blood pressure. Maybe many of you have. I just told him, you massage the cow 5 minutes a day in the morning and 5 minutes in the evening on her back. Within a week, his blood pressure was normal. If anybody has indigenous cows nearby, I will request you to please try this for 8 to 10 days and then after that come back to us. It will work. Thank you very much. Jai Gomata. Hare Krishna.